watching the screen of a microcomputer system, a personal computer, one of a half a dozen or so on the market today. Components include a microcomputer beneath a keyboard, a viewer, and an ordinary audio cassette player. 15 years ago, the computer alone would have cost $1 million and would have taken up an entire 20 by 20 foot room. Today, the whole system sells for around $600. Information for the systems is stored on tape cassettes. The cassettes can be purchased with stock market data, measurement conversions for recipes, even games like the blackjack card game simulation you've been watching. The program manual for this nationally distributed system was written by Dr. David Lean, Grossmont College Vocational Education Dean.
I hear some concern, some people saying, look at all the computers coming out on the market. This looks like 1984 is really racing up on us. I don't believe that. I think it's just the opposite, and I think it's very healthy, because instead of seeing the centralization of data in large computers that talk to each other on telephone lines and through space satellites, we're seeing decentralization of data, where every businessman, regardless how small, will have his own data centralized in his own store, and I think it's a very healthy move away from 1984, if you will. And the type of thing we're seeing happen and the capabilities that we're seeing the computer able to execute leads a lot of people, me included, to believe that we really are on the edge of an entirely new industrial revolution.
The uses for these computer systems are unlimited. Education, job training, entertainment, even expert income tax advice for doing your taxes at home. The systems are limited only in that production of tape programs is lagging. But production will catch up, and in a few years, providing you have one of these systems, you'll have information on just about anything, and you'll have it in your own home. Despite all these machines can do, they really don't have a mind of their own, so you have nothing to fear. I think it's trying to tell me something. Tomorrow's Saturday, maybe it'd like to go to the zoo. Doug McAllister, TV8 News, San Carlos.